मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू SST सो सिंपल ट्यूटोरियल। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी रेड अबाउट द नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट इन टाउन्स एंड इट्स इकोनॉमिक इंपैक्ट। टुडे वी विल रीड रिबेलियन इन द कंट्री साइड। फर्स्ट वी विल सी द स्ट्रगल्स ऑफ पीजेंट्स, देन वी विल सी द ट्राइबल्स पार्टिसिपेशन। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कंट्री साइड? Countryside means the land which is away from towns and cities. By countryside, we generally mean rural areas. From the cities, the non-cooperation movement spread to the countryside. Gandhiji got the support of all sections of people. In towns, we found students, we found teachers, lawyers, etc. supporting the movement. In the countryside, thousands of peasants responded to the call of non-cooperation. The participation of peasants actually gave this movement a mass character in many parts of the country. But here we will not discuss the participation of peasants from all over the country. We will discuss the peasants' participation of our region only. Then we will see the participation of tribals of Gudem Hills of Andhra Pradesh. Awadh is the northeastern portion of Uttar Pradesh today. It included Lucknow, Allahabad, Ayodhya, etc. In the old historical texts, you will also find Awadh with different spellings like Awadh, A-V-A-D-H, O-U-D-H, but you don't have to worry. They mean the same. In Awadh region, peasants were led by Baba Ramchandra. Baba Ramchandra was a sannyasi who had been to Fiji as an indentured labor. On his return to India, he settled in Ayodhya and became a sadhu, holy man. He organized the peasants of Awadh and led the peasants against the landlords. In 1919, he led the first protest against the landlords. Here, the peasants were against the jamindars and talukdars who used to demand very high rent from them. The jamindars forced the peasants to do begar. Do you understand begar? Begar is a practice where a worker is forced to render service to the master free of charge or at nominal remuneration. They were also unhappy as they had no security of tenure. They were regularly evicted so that they could not acquire rights over the leased land. So what you find here is that the peasants were against the jamindars and talukdars and not in direct confrontation with the British. Let us now see the demands of peasants. What were the demands of the peasants? The peasants demanded reduction of revenue, the abolition of begar, and the social boycott of oppressive landlords. In some places, Nai Dhobi Band were organized by the panchayats. Nai means the barber and Dhobi means washerman. This kind of band was actually meant to deprive landlords from the services of barbers and washermen. In June 1920, Jawaharlal Nehru was touring around the villages of our region. He was talking to them, he was listening to their problems, he was trying to understand their grievances. By 1920, Baba Ramchandra organized all the farmers' associations in Awadh, and by October, Awadh Kisan Sabha was set up, headed by Jawaharlal Nehru, Baba Ramchandra and few others. Soon, more than 300 branches were set up in that region. So, when the non-cooperation movement began in 1921, the Congress wanted to bring this peasant struggle into its fold. By associating itself with the peasants' movement, Congress wanted to make non-cooperation movement a wider movement. So the peasants participated in the movement. They attacked the houses of talukdars and landlords. They looted the bazaars and took over the hoarded grains. At many places, they stopped paying rents by invoking the name of Mahatma Gandhi. So the way movement developed it made Congress leaders unhappy. My dear students, have you heard of Bardoli Satyagraha? You can see your textbook just below the activity. Bardoli is a taluka in Gujarat. Bardoli Satyagraha was a peasant movement led by Sardar Patel in 1928. It was against enhancement of land revenue. Due to this movement, the government of Bombay Presidency, which had raised the tax by 22%, decided to bring it down to about 6%. Patel actually became Sardar after this incident. It were the women of Bardoli who actually bestowed the title Sardar, which means chief. You may have one more question from here. What was Bardoli movement, or who led the Bardoli movement? Let us now see the next topic. Under rebellion in the countryside, we saw the struggles of the peasants. Now we will see the case of tribals, particularly from the Gudem Hills of Andhra Pradesh. In the early 1920s, a militant guerrilla movement started in the Gudem Hills of Andhra Pradesh after the implementation of the Forest Act. Dear students, last year Forest Society and Colonialism was deleted from your history syllabus of class 9. So this forest law may sound something new to you. I will just give you an idea about the act. In order to manage the forests properly, the Britishers enacted Forest Act in 1865. Thereafter, it was amended in 1878 and in 1927. The Act of 1878 divided forests into three categories: reserved forests, protected forests, and village forests. The best ones were called reserved forests. Villagers could not take anything from these forests, even for their own use. Cutting wood for their houses, grazing the cattle, collecting fruit, hunting, fishing had become illegal. So this Forest Act meant hardships for the villagers living in and around the forests, whose livelihood depended on these forests. Okay. So, when the forest laws were implemented, it meant that the tribals of Gudem Hills were prevented from entering the forests to graze cattle or to collect fruits and firewood. The new forest laws were a threat to their livelihood. Besides this, the government forced them to do begar for road construction also. So, the result was that the hill people revolted. They attacked the police stations and attempted to kill British officials. Many rebels from the tribal areas became non-violent and carried out guerrilla warfare for achieving Swaraj. The name of person who led them was Ellore Sitaram Raju. He claimed that he had many special powers. He could make correct astrological predictions. He could heal people. He could even survive bullet shots. He was inspired by the non-cooperation movement. He talked about the greatness of Mahatma Gandhi. He persuaded people to wear khadi and give up drinking. But he asserted that India could be liberated only by force and not non-violence. Raju was captured and executed in 1924. Thus, we come to the end of the topic, rebellion in the countryside. I hope you understood the topic properly. Let us now go and see the question part. Students, now you should be able to answer these questions. 1. Who was Baba Ramchandra? 2. What were the problems faced by the peasants of Awadh? What were the major demands of the peasants who participated in the non-cooperation movement? Who was Ellore Sitaram Raju? Why the tribals participated in the non-cooperation Khilafat movement? What methods were adopted by the tribals to gain Swaraj? Dear students, let me stop here now. In the meantime, you read your textbook and watch the video again if needed. In the next class, We will continue with the same unit and discuss Swaraj in the plantations. Till then, keep reading and have a nice time. Thank you.